Hi everybody, in this video we will see how to build a UDP multicast client that connects to a UDP NW server. I'm using elecard NW server application, which can be found in the C program file elecard tools. You can find it NW server. This is the C# version. Okay, so I have a very long file, a transport file that I want to play it using a UDP. This is the UDP multicast address and this is the port. So I'm starting the server now. To build the filter graph, I build a UDP multicast client that currently doesn't use any interface but just a constant IP address. A note that in order to connect to the elecard push the multiplexer, okay, in order that the output pin will reveal very fast. Okay, there is a trick here that what I did is that I prepare a file, a small file, like 4 mega file. And this transport file, when the filter is not connected, I'm giving the multiplexer, I'm giving the file instead of waiting for a connection. Currently, there is a connection because this one is already playing, but even though there is no connection, it will connect. So now I can use the elecard AVC decoder and start the rendering and play the video. And the video should play immediately. Which it some reason it doesn't. Okay, now it does. Okay, so what we have here is a very simple UDP socket that connects and join a membership, join a membership to the multicast address. And once it connects, let me show you here. This is the address. And when it decides the meta size, which means that the connection starts, I'm starting the thread. And here I'm receiving, waiting for receiving. And there is two options. One, when there is no connection, when the select timing is zero, which means there is no connection. And the other thing is there, where is connection? And where is the connection? If the graph is running, I'm adding the frame from the UDP. Otherwise, I am giving the frame from the from the file, and the result is that it can connect and reveal the pin immediately and play every time. So, by the way, when it start and stop, I don't do anything, which means I don't close the thread connection and just let the graph stop, which means that when it stopped it and there is a connection, it's still waiting here. And again, let's see, what if we are adding the pin again, and we will see that it revealed the pin again and again. let's see if it's working again. Yep, and it's working. Which means that all the functionality that connect and disconnect the filter, it's working, and you can do it again and again. So the trick here is to give a file to the MPEG, the multiplexer, give him a pre-dump file so he can reveal the pin immediately. But this is only for the same the same video. Okay, if we want this pin to have a different PID and a different different pin, then we need to wait for the data. But in a project that when you know what is your incoming video, okay, and just want to play to build a fast player, then you can give him the pin. So it's much better than we don't want to build the standard standard source client that wait to any kind of source. We know that the source, this is the source that we are waiting for, and therefore we will give him the file and we will create the theme. So the source code can be found in my GitLab, and the file, you just can create any MPEG-TS file, put it on somewhere in C or somewhere else, and use this multicast client. That's it.